it's just important to keep in mind that we've really made a mistake when we've started to equate mindfulness with meditation. Meditation is a path to mindfulness, but it's not mindful. You know, the goal is mindful living, not meditation. So the idea of all the other skills is, how could you live your life all the time in wise mind? Okay, or as a centered person, whatever terms you want to use. I mean, I don't have to cling to these particular words, but the concepts are general concepts. Okay, so now we've got mindfulness what? So this is what to do. So there are three: observing, describing, participating. And these three you can only do one at a time. And you can't do more than one. So what is observing? Observing, I'm sure those of you in the room know what it is. It's paying attention to direct experience at the level of sensation. The way I always teach is to have clients put their hands on a table, but I'll ask you to put your hand just on your thigh or on your book or on your piece of paper or on something, and simply notice the sensations of your hand. And when your mind goes off to a sound, like a telephone ringing, just bring it right back to the sensations of your hand. So, is direct perception mediated neither by institution nor by language? In other words, it's direct sensation. Now, what you're trying to teach is how to sense without describing, and many people cannot do that. All right? When I first started, I didn't even know what they were talking about. I learned all this stuff first in this spiritual direction. It was Shalane, for those of you from Urban D.C., Shalane. It's a spiritual, sort of like a spiritual training group. And they would say things like that. I couldn't even imagine how you could sense something and not describe it. You know, I hear, go, go, whatever, chip, chip, bird. I mean, it never even occurred to me that it was possible to actually sense something and not put some words on. I was extraordinarily verbal. So, many clients are like that. It can be very difficult. You should give them your own examples, like I'm giving you, and just say not to worry about it. Just notice the word that goes through their mind and keep right on paying attention to sensations. There are lots of ways to teach this, other than watching your breath, as it turns out. You can bring in a million things. And we've brought herbs, we've gone to herb gardens, I've brought in flowers, we've brought in scents, we've brought in touch, we've brought in sounds. You know, anything you can think of is something to practice, okay? We can have people, our clients really like watching candles, you can put a candle in. Obviously, you can have people watch their breath. You can have them watch muscle. You can do sensate. The sensate focus and mindfulness-based treatment is exactly this. You, in an insight meditation, you just watch your sensations. Okay, so the idea is to bring things, but to do it briefly with people who can't do it for long periods of time. Then you can, I usually start with, many people can't really pay a lot of attention to internal sensations because they have PTSD or they'll have other things or they're too anxious or they panic. So you can also start out with watching outside. A really good one is to sit somewhere and then watch what goes by in front of you without turning your head. Okay, very difficult, it turns out, to do. Most of us like to follow things, okay? But when you're just watching, you're watching just what goes by, okay? And you have people start really noticing, notice other people's faces, notice what other people are saying, notice trees. I used to have a client who I worked with, a physician, and he would say, he'd say to his wife, I got to go out and get a leaf. I'll be back. And they'd go out and get leaves and watch the leaves, which were very calming, you know. So people who like nature, you can send them out on walks in nature. There are a million places that you can practice. The secret to the practice is you're doing a mindful, you know, effortful, actual practice. Like what I'm doing now is observing, okay? The trick is to try to get that sense of observing what's going on around you, noticing allowing, controlling your attentions, being alert, like a palace at the gate, really alert, you know, like now a better one, the palace at the gate part would be, you know, in, you think of the military and the person who's at the head of a line and in Iraq or something, you know, you're alert, you're like this, and there's nothing that's going to go by you, don't see it. It's that wide awake, it's being awake, wide awake. It's having a Teflon mind. Observing is not attaching. Observing is noticing. So what goes through your mind, you think of it's like your mind is just a Teflon plate and things just slip through, they slip right out. A lot of clients have commented on how helpful the concept of Teflon mind is. They get it right away and it's very helpful.